Hello guys, my name is Hardevinder. Today we are going to solve this question paper, Cambridge Assessment International Education. This paper 31. Today we are going to cover this data analysis part. In the previous video we have already covered the website of Thing. So in this video we are going to cover data analysis. Let us start. This is a paper of February March 2019. Let us start with the data analysis. Before starting, I want to inform you that for solving this paper, we are using a operating system. This Ubuntu operating system we are going to use, and the LibreOffice, Libre Calculator, and Libre Writer we are going to use for solving this paper. So listen, this part we have already covered in my previous video, task 1 and task 2. So let us start with the task 3. Here is task 3 spreadsheet. 50 marks out of 80 we have already covered in the previous video. In this video the rest 30 marks we will cover. So let us start with the task 3, that is a spreadsheet. You are going to prepare spreadsheet model for use by employees of Gloria's Glorious Gardens. Open these files in a spreadsheet package and examine their contents. So firstly, we need to open these all three files: trees, CSV, category.csv, and tree course.csv. Three these files from the source folder we need to copy, means we need to open and examine these. In pre-spreadsheet, place your name, center number, and candidate number on the right in the header, and automated file name including the file path on the left in the footer. So let us check. So this is our source file, and here we have the files category.csv, open in a spreadsheet format. And here is tree course. And here is trees. Trees and tree course has not opened yet. Let me check again. These are tree course. So these three files we have opened: tree course, trees, and category. So let me check. This file contains codes of the trees, means W for wet soil code, environment factors means depends, and L lime, E for susceptible, and Dutch diseases, A acid soil, and it's different. These are the codes and these are the environment factors for these codes. W means this, and L means this, and tree codes, and these are trees. This complete tree information, common name, Latin name, code, category, height of the tree, L code, T code, D code, likes, and let us see further for what purpose. These are the categories. Okay. So, four time I think we have opened this category. Category.csv, tree codes, trees, tree codes. Twice we have opened, so once we can close it. Three files are already opened. So let's move further. We need to place your name, center number, and candidate number on the right in the header, and automated file name including the path on the left in the footer. In trees, file, there is a trees file. Format, then go in page. Insert header and footer. This header, this is a footer, and in the header they have told us your name, center number, and candidate number on the right in the header. The name, suppose your name is Hardevinder Singh, then candidate number and center number and candidate number. Center number, suppose your center number is N0001, and your candidate number is suppose 0001. and they have told an automated file name including the file path on the left in the footer. A footer in the left, we need to add the automatic file path and file name. This we have placed. This 2 marks task we have already covered, and press OK. Let us move further. In tree spreadsheet, insert the new rows before row 1 added file so that it look like this. Three rows we need to insert, and we need to write these headings, this heading and subheading, and it should look like that in trees. This is a trees, insert 3 rows, 1, 2, 3. Now right click and insert rows above. Let us merge them up to here. Then write this glorious garden. It is written glorious. Let me copy this. Instead of just writing, we can copy and just paste here and increase its size. Should be I think 20. It is okay. Writing this, and background color you can change this one, and foreground color should be white. Yeah. Then we need to write native British trees and shrubs. I think we need to merge all and then assign it in the right. Merge it. This is native British trees and shrubs. Native British trees and shrubs. Align it right and increase its size more. Make it bold. It's okay. Let's move further. Save this as a spreadsheet with the file name trees followed by your center number and candidate number, for example this. Now we need to save it. We can save this file in a spreadsheet format in a new folder, that is a work area. I have already created a folder work area. In this this file we can save in a spreadsheet format. Right now we have opened this file. This is in a CSV format. We need to save it in a spreadsheet format. Let us save as, and we need to write the file name trees, and here the center number. Suppose your center number is n 0001 and your candidate number is 3 times 0 and 1, and where we will save it in a work area here, and say it will ask for, this is ODF, means that this spreadsheet format, this is CSV format. We need to save it in a spreadsheet format. This has been saved. Take a screenshot showing all the cells A1 to M5 of your spreadsheet, including a row and column headings. Make sure contents of the cells are fully visible. A1 to M5 we need to take its screenshot. It should show row headings as well as column headings, and we need to place it. Let's take a screenshot. Select the grab area screen. Need to A1 to M5 up to here. So let me save it on your desktop. A file, copy it and open your work area folder. Here I have already made our evidence document. Here we need to save it. here we can write IV tense 7. Here we can place that screenshot, that is this one. Okay. Enter a function in D5 to look up the type of tree or shrub. From the source file category.csv, do not edit the source file. The L-code, T-code or D-code column hold codes for whether the tree or that is another question. This 5 marks question we have to cover now. Enter a function in cell D5 to look up the type of tree or shrub from the source file category.csv. We need to open trees file in a cell D5. Here is D5. We need to write the category according to that code. Tree codes, from tree codes we will pick the category. This is a lookup value. Matching to this code, the particular category should be printed here. This is our target. So means here is a tree codes. Not tree codes. I think they have asked for the type category here. Sorry. This LT means large tree. If there is a written LT matching to this LT here, in that category should be printed large tree. MT matching to MT, that should print medium tree. ST small tree, in like this. So let us make the function. Here we need a lookup function. Lookup function, it contains parameters like VLOOKUP. First parameter is lookup value. From where this is a lookup value. We will pick the lookup value, then comma, then we need the array. Array means from where we need to pick the category, we need to select that. Here is a category, yes. Select these, then comma, and then it will ask for the index. Index means from where we need to pick, from which column we need to pick the values. We need to pick from the type here. This is a second column, first, second, means second column. From second column matching to this lookup value, we need the category from the second column. So right here, second, two. So here the third parameter is, that is a column index, from where, which column we need to pick the values, and then it will ask for the sorting order 0 or 1. If the value is true or not given, the search column of the array must be sorted in ascending order. 1 means true and 0 means false. If we will write here 0, then it's okay. From where we are picking the values, that may be a ascending or descending order, any order. If we are writing a 1 means true, then the values must be in a ascending order. But we don't know the values are in ascending or descending order, so that's why we can write the 0. So it's better. So right here. So view show formulas. Yeah, LT means large tree. Now we need to absolute the reference. Where is the reference? Means a table array should be in a absolute format. Let me show you. There is a formula. These arrays A1 to C7 from the category file we are picking, these should be in an absolute reference. There should be a this right now, this is in a relative reference. Relative means when we will drop down, when we replicate the function down, then automatically the cell reference will change. But we want that the cell reference should not change. Let me show you, for example, suppose I copy this formula to here. This reference A1 to A2, but if we will check the category, we need the same reference up to here. It should not change, it should not be from here to here now. So that's why we need to make it absolute. For making it absolute, we can place our cursor here and press F4. It will make it absolute. And up to here also, we can place it and press F4. So making it absolute. Now we can copy. So let you check me. This A1 remains same. If we will not make it absolute, by default it will be a relative. So relative means it will change the reference when we will replicate the function. We don't want to change, so now replicate all to here. So this has been done according to this lookup. Empty means small medium tree, and LT large, and ST small tree. These things have been done. Let's move further. This task we have already done, 5 marks task. Do not edit the source file. Not the L code, T code, and D code columns holds hold codes for whether a tree or shrub likes, tolerates, or dislikes certain environment factors. Enter function in cell I5, J5, and K5 to look up the environment factors from the source file treecodes.csv. Do not edit the source file. Make sure that when these functions are used, they do not display any error message. So keep in mind these 3 points. We'll need to write the functions in I5, J5, K5. So let us check from where, which is the source file. The source file is treecodes. So let us see I5. Firstly, we need to write the function in I5. There is I and here is 5. Here in I5, we need to pick the lookup the values L code, and if there is no L code, then it should not print any error message. This is a condition. So let us make the function here. Again, we need VLOOKUP. Then first is a lookup value. Then comma table array. Table array we need to pick from the tree codes. Where are the tree codes? These are tree codes. Then we need to column index here in tree codes is 2 1 2. Here matching to this, we need to print this environment factor, that is 2, and 0 means false, and approximate match. So let me drop down. If the code is available, then it's printing the its environment factor. If it's not showing. We need to make the reference absolute also. Again, here we can press F4 and again up here. Click and let me check again. So again check, if the code is not available, it's showing this error message. If code is available, accordingly this is printing. But the condition was that if the code is not there, let me show you again. Make sure then when the function are used by, they do not display any error message. Means error message should not be displayed like this. Means if code is not available, then it should not print any error message. Means it should be a blank. For making this, we need to more function in that. We can make if function here. If the value here is equal to blank, then it should print blank else this lookup function. let me replicate the function again. So guys, now it's okay, we have made the function. Let me show you again. If in F5 the value code is not there, means blank, then it will print blank, otherwise this VLOOKUP function will work out. And now with the same function we need to write here in J5. Now we will pick toret, means we need to pick look up the value from here. Again we need to write the function, same function we can copy this function with the control C and control V for paste. Everything is okay, but just we need to change this reference. Tree codes, everything same. Okay, the lookup value is now G5. Earlier here it was F5 and now it is G5 by copying, just because we have not made it absolute. So we are copying here, it is automatically changing its reference F5 to G5. So don't need to write the function again, just copy and then replicate. Now the same function we need in this line. So this 19th question we have solved, 6 marks this already. Replicate the functions entered in steps 18 and 19 so that results are displayed and full trees. This we have already done, we already have replicated the functions. Hide column C, F, G and H. Now hide hide columns, and then save and print the spreadsheet showing the formula. Make sure only rows from 1 to 29 are visible. It is a landscape orientation. Row and columns headings are displayed. The contents of all the cells are fully visible. Spreadsheet showing the formulas. For showing the formulas, we can go in view and show formula. It will show and then take its printout in the landscape format. For this we need to go in format, then page, and here we can show column and row headings print, and just by doing this we can go and select the rows from up to 29 as they have told and then take the printout. Then next, create a spreadsheet, extract from the data to show trees or shrubs that are a small trees, large shrub or medium shrub, evergreen. Let us check this again. View, show formula, where is show? Yeah, yes. So now we need to extract, print the spreadsheet, extract showing the values. Make sure that print out create the spreadsheet, extract from the data to show trees or shrubs that are small trees, large shrub or medium shrub. So let we put the filter here. We need to print only small trees, large shrub and medium shrub. large sharp and medium sharp only. Then okay, we have filter out the values. Evergreen, evergreen, where is evergreen? I think we need to evergreen. Yes, okay. Now they have told the extract must display only the common name, like torrent, dislike, evergreen and nodes column only. Other columns we can hide and take the printout. We need to show common name, then likes, torrents, dislikes, evergreen. This column we need to hide, then up to here we need to hide all these things. Hide L code, torrent, D code, likes, then dislikes, evergreen and nodes. Only these columns we need to display, and then we can take its printout. Printout fits all single page, header, footers, contents, specified cells are fully visible. Save the evidence document and then okay. This question has we have already told solved, and you can take the printout 2 and printout 3 in this way. We have solved all paper. Thanks for watching. Next time we will solve the Word document paper 21. Thank you. Thank you very much.